Now my biggest focus is bringing all the best of the SaaS world, you know, features and ease of use and usability inside the ecosystem, which, you know, powers 35% of the web. Yeah, sure, I don't get 100% of the users, but I get a pretty large chunk of the 35% of the web.
You've grown a lot lately through acquisitions.
Yeah.
Tell me about the first time that you did that. I know sometimes you can't talk about things. So
right.
Within the bounds of pick one that you can talk about. And I'd love to hear what was the experience like going from, I've never done that before, to, hey, I'd kind of like to buy that.
Yeah. So I realized, you know, every year I would do a census survey on WP Beginner, and it had like a bunch of questions. But one of my favorite questions, which we ask all the time, is if you could have us build one product, what would it be? Mm-hmm. And how much would you pay for it?
Mm-hmm. Right? I like the end. How much would you pay for it?
So people would give us, and the answer kept coming, contact form. And I'm like, wait, contact form, this market is well served already. There are so many, like hundreds of contact form plugins out in WordPress and then outside. What is wrong? So we started doing interviews, and people were like, oh, it's not user friendly, that's the issue, blah, blah, like dozens of issues, right? So I started trying to buy a contact form company, and nobody wanted to do it. So I said, okay, I'm going to build my own. Mm-hmm. But I figured out that I need to buy. Mm-hmm. That's the way to go. And then the second—
Because it was going to take too much time.
Too much time to build, right, from the ground up, and have feature parity with established competitors who have like 7 years advantage on you.
Right.
The other thing was analytics. People kept asking analytics. I'm like, wait, what's the issue with analytics? Yoast already had the product call for analytics. And I'm like, I don't even know if Yoast is going to sell this to me. So I reached out to a smaller player in the market, mm-hmm. And start talking to me like, well, no, actually, I actually just partnered with somebody else, so I really can't sell this. And just out of the blue, Yoast pings me on Skype. He's like, hey, do you want to buy this?
Had he heard, or?
I have no idea.
Just random. Just
completely
just like
random.
Out of the sky.
Out of the sky.
And did you know Yoast?
Yeah. I mean, we've been in the same space.
So he was thinking, hey, I kind of don't want this anymore.
Correct.
I'll talk to the people that might be interested.
Yeah, exactly.
That's
he had a good
cool.
reputation in the space, and he knew that I was looking in the plugin space. I never communicated with him that I wanted to buy an analytics software. He just reached out. He's like, hey, you're somebody I trust. I want to, like, you know, I'm happy to sell you this business because I wanted to go in the hand of somebody who's not going to abuse the user base. That's the big concern,
that's
right?
That's really cool. Yeah.
And I'm like, dude, what are the odds that I was really looking for an analytics software?
Right.
Let's make it happen. And it was a quick deal because there was so much trust between the parties involved.
Was it concerning? I'm assuming you had to pay a reasonable amount of money for it.
Yeah.
Okay. Was it scary at all going and doing that?
No.
Or was it so well established?
We had a pretty good business. You know, being bootstrapped, we've been pretty financially conservative.
Yeah.
We keep a good cash flow to make investments and things. So mm-hmm. we had the cash in the bank. So we just went, okay, we'll acquire it.
Yeah. And you knew it was not a big risk.
Yeah, it wasn't a huge risk for us. And it was aligned very well to cross sell and things like that. We took it, and I knew it was under optimized because that Yoast's main focus was SEO business and not an analytics software.
Yeah.
So we're able to go in, make quick improvements, recover our money way, way faster. And I'm like, this is really cool. We need to do this. And then as WP Forms started, so we took WP Forms from 0 to 2 million in 3 years.
Wow.
And user base wise, you know, which is unreal. Like the fastest growing form solution in the market right now.
So these were acquisitions for money, basically. No
Correct.
Trade swaps.
No.
Super creative.
Yeah,
there.
No.
Just
no.
Get the best deal you can.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So those would be examples of line extensions, basically, or market extensions. You've
right.
got the same market of WordPress users. You're giving the similar kind of products that go that are compatible with the ones you've
right.
got.
Right. Yeah.
And did that extend outside of, because Optin Monster had already gone to SaaS
yes.
solution.
Yeah.
Did you also plan to take those products outside of the WordPress environment?
No, because when you operate in an ecosystem, you have some inherent advantages.
Uh-huh.
You know exactly who your market is. You know exactly how to market to them. You can work out distribution deals much better than anything else. Versus outside, it's a level playing field. Anybody can go on Facebook and bid.
Yeah.
Your moat isn't that large.
Got it.
In WordPress, we have a pretty large moat. We own the biggest media site. We have extremely great reputation. We have extremely great relationships for being in the space so long. And, you know, we have channel partners, agency partners, distribution partners. I need to focus, just double down on this area because we have an unfair advantage.
Yeah.
So when we got WP Forms, I'm like, I'm not going to go compete with WooFoo or SurveyMonkey, which is a $1 billion business, or Typeform. I'm going to bring the best of all those platforms into WordPress.
Into the ecosystem.
Because people in this ecosystem don't want to go compete with, you right. know, or use those outside softwares.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I, like now my biggest focus is bringing all the best of the SaaS world, you know, features and ease of use and usability inside the ecosystem, which, you know, powers 35% of the web. Yeah, sure, I don't get 100% of the users, but I get a pretty large chunk of 35% of the web.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome. So you started acquiring these things now, you've expanded. And what were the other big takeaways from these acquisitions? You mentioned that you had a lot from,
yeah.
you know, from doing this.
So the biggest thing I learned was that, you know, if you have imposter syndrome as an entrepreneur, mm-hmm. you're like, oh, am I really qualified to do this? Am mm-hmm. I really good at this? But when you acquire the business, I'm like, oh, I actually... I'm pretty far ahead in this thing, right? I need to go do more of this. I need to do more. And then that kind of gave birth to us like looking at, you know, other alignments. Cause we're like, it's a lot easier to cross sell our own products. And
of
the more
course.
We can do it,
you already
right?
have the buyers.
We already
and they
have
already
the
know you and like yeah, you and trust you.
Exactly. Right. So you have the famous KLT, you know, like trust. I'm yeah. like, okay, how, what else can we add? What other problems can we solve? And then it just opened a thing. I knew the process, like how to outreach. My brand was well known. Said, okay, we have WP Forms. One of the big problems that users have, their WordPress emails don't get delivered because their hosting companies are not SMTP service, right? Okay, what's the problem? Well, everybody's recommending this SMTP plugin. It exists. It has 600,000 users. All my competitors are recommending it. And let me see, who owns this? One developer. Well, let me just approach him, see if he would sell it to me. And then I can call it WP Mail SMTP by WP Forms. Mm-hmm. And now I can market to all of my competitors with, you know, users.
Yeah, yeah.
And our brand goes out. Bought that. Okay, that's pretty cool. All right, what else can we? So then I said, you know what? I want to work within the ecosystem and work with other entrepreneurs because I really enjoyed networking with entrepreneurs. And we had a pretty healthy cash flow and everything. I'm like, I need to reinvest this. And I understand the ecosystem. I have an unfair advantage. So I created my own growth fund and I started investing nice. Into other companies. And that so I launched the accelerator and it was just like, hey, I can add a lot of value because we have the user base for the cross-sell point of view while taking an equity stake into businesses. So then we acquired a stake into Formidable Forms, which is an alternative to WP Forms. WP Forms focused on more business and beginner users. Formidable mm-hmm. is very advanced, focused on developer and does tons of unique, cool things. So we took a stake in that. We're like, okay, essential software, you have membership is a platform level software. I'm like, okay, cool. We already know that there's a big need. Membership sites are growing, membership economy, you know, mm-hmm. you read the book. It's like the culture shift. So I'm like, oh, like MemberPress is a software. I know the guy, I like him. Approached them, took a stake in that company. They had a suite of software, Pretty Links, Affiliate Royale. So now we're in affiliate marketing space as well.
So cool.
I'm like, okay, what else? You know, what are the success gaps when you're starting a WordPress website? Well, a lot of people don't know.
How do you define a success gap?
There are two types. One is external, like what your product does and what the customer needs for them to be successful. Mm-hmm. So that gap could be anything in a WordPress, you know, form plugin. Well, they need to have a first WordPress website. They need to have training. They need to have marketing. They need to have all that thing, right? So that's external. And internal is what your product does and what the customer thinks it should do for them mm-hmm. to be successful. And that could be like, you know, forms. Well, they want us to create surveys, but like we're like, oh, you can create surveys. Well, they don't really want surveys. The user wants beautiful reports. So that's the success gap. So I'm talking about external success gap, we wanted to fill it. So I'm looking at, okay, when you start a WordPress website, what's the gap? What's the natural flow of users? I started thinking about, you know, really mind like small details. Before you choose a theme, it's really hard to choose a theme. There are like thousands of them out there. People just put up a coming soon page.
Right.
And I'm like, wait a minute, that's a great entry point to bring our products more exposure. Let me go acquire the most popular coming soon page plugin.
Nice.
So we did. So just started looking, you know, so we just
especially
started.
Actually, what's cool about it is that you're in a system that is a confined system.
Yep.
And you have the dominant system. So there's how many WordPress installations are there over the world?
Hundreds of millions.
Yeah, hundreds of millions. So it's a giant market,
right,
even though it is an ecosystem, mm-hmm. right? And what's cool about it is that there isn't, because of the open source nature, a dominant player.
Right.
So as anybody who's innovating, mm-hmm. you just come along and say, that's cool. Hey, want to sell it to me? Or hey, want to partner?
Right.
Or hey, want our fund to throw some money your way? It's so cool. So smart.
Yeah.